slide you have in front of you that was filed by Mr. Emmanuel Costas. And the affidavit, the registration is dated 9/21/2016. I want to remind you that the voter registration process itself requires that an affidavit be completed by the voter under oath. If a voter registers to vote by mail, then in order for them to actually cast a ballot, whether it be an early voting ballot, an absentee ballot, or a ballot on election day, they have to show identification. If they do not show an acceptable form of identification, they're provided with a provisional ballot, and their identification is further examined before a decision can be made as to whether to count the ballot. It is highly unlikely that a person that registers to vote by mail and does not appear at the polls with ID, that even that further investigation would allow their ballot to be cast. So I just want to make sure that we understand that. As you can see from examining the affidavit in this case, the full name was Emmanuel Costas Jr. And then it says former name, and says Hernandez Rodrigo, and again, Jr. And then it lists 6 Burning Tree Lane, the address where they received mail is the same. No identification is written, and the last known address where they were registered to vote was San Pedro, Mexico. And I discussed this with the town clerk. None of these things in and of themselves would lead to a conclusion that that the person was incorrectly or improperly registered, or that they made a false statement in their affidavit. However, a confirmation notice, which I believe you have in front of you, was sent to 6 Burning Tree Lane as required by law. And when that was done, the current residents called the town clerk's office to inquire as to what this matter was about, why they were getting mail for Mr. Emmanuel Costas at their address, and they assured the town clerk's office that no such person resided at that address. Those factors combined, in my opinion, created a question for the clerk's office, and the clerk reached out both to council and to the state elections division to say, how do we handle this? And that is exactly what the process is supposed to do. The confirmation notice is sent, one, to make sure the person wrote their address correctly, but also so that if, in fact, there was an attempt to register an address where a person does not actually reside, that information would immediately become apparent. It is highly unusual to reject an affidavit of current of registration. And so this process played out the way that it ought to have. And once that information became apparent, the town clerk and I discussed next steps. Pursuant to General Laws Chapter 51, Section 47B, the town's Board of Registrars has the ability to file a complaint under General Laws Chapter 51, Section 48, and they would need to find, the board would need to find that there was probable cause to believe that there was an incorrect statement or a false statement in the affidavit, and or the Board of Registrars has the right under General Laws Chapter 51, Section 48 to bring a complaint if they have reason to believe and do believe that a person is incorrectly registered at an address.